You and I, we are so random. You bring the darkness to the light, split the atom. I ignore the fact that this will never last. Your words come out so soothing that I forget that this thing is confusing.
Hey guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel. If it's your first time here, welcome. My name is Anne, and if you have been here already, welcome back. So in today's video, I'm gonna play with the KKW and Makeup by Mario, the Artist and Muse palette. I think the packaging looks incredible. I love that Kim K and Mario are on it. And the inside looks like this. It has a lot of beautiful neutral colors. It has one blue shade, but that one I think is also kind of neutral. So I think this is like a really nice palette for every day. I have this palette now for a few weeks, but I just didn't really know what to do with it. I was kind of out of inspiration, like sometimes that happens to me. So I decided to do a recreation of the look that Kim K is wearing right here. I absolutely love the makeup, so I just wanted to do something kind of similar, even though like it's not exactly the same because I didn't know like what shades Mario used on her. So I think mine actually turned out a little bit more cool tone. So in this video, I'm showing you how I created this eye look, but also I'm playing with the blush, the lipstick and the gloss, which comes in the same collection. And I think we're just gonna dive right into the video. I hope you guys will enjoy.
So the first thing I'm gonna do is prime my eyelids. I'm using the MAC Cosmetics Soft Ochre Paint Pot, which is my absolutely favorite shadow primer. I use it in almost every video. I just really like it. It has a yellow undertone, so it kind of hides the redness from the eyelid. Also, it will make sure that my eyeshadow will stay in place all day, and of course, that is what we want. Then I'm taking the KKW Makeup by Mario palette, which they recently launched. Such a beautiful palette with a lot of neutral colors. And today I'm gonna create the look that I already showed you guys at the intro. So the first color I'm going in with is called Don't Move. I'm taking a blending brush from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I'm not sure what the number is, but this is the only brush they have which has like black hairs at the end and is white for the rest of the brush. And I'm gonna start with blending that in the crease. I'm not going all the way from the inner corner to the outer corner. I'm more focusing with blending it upwards towards my brow in the middle part. This way I'm gonna create a sort of deep set crease, which I'm kind of going for today. Then now I'm going next in with the color I'm Inspired, taking that same brush. I'm just following the line that I just created with that previous color, just blending on top of it just to create like some more darkness. And this is kind of gonna intensify that crease area. By doing this, I also want to focus on the outer V area, because with this eyeshadow look, I'm not going for a winged liner. So I want the outer V area to be really nicely blended out. So I'm also focusing in that area, as you can see me doing right now. And also I press the eyeshadow kind of in that area as well to make sure that there's like enough product. So when I'm done with that, I'm gonna take some concealer. I'm taking the Benefit Cosmetics Boying Cakeless Concealer, which is a really nice concealer. I'm using it to kind of create a clean base on the middle part of the eyelid. Also at the inner corner area, as you can see me doing, I'm just kind of tapping the product on, and at the same time, I'm softly blending the product. I don't want there to be like harsh edges around the edges of where I'm applying the concealer. So I'm really softly kind of blending it more and more towards the middle parts. And also I'm kind of trying to apply it right underneath the crease, the kind of the fake crease that I created. This way the line of the eyeshadow that I applied is kind of gonna be more obvious, because we're applying the concealer underneath it, so the line is gonna more stand out, if that makes sense. And then I took this color, which is called So Many Paparazzi, and I'm applying this on top of where I just applied the concealer to kind of lock it in place. And also this is more of a yellowy undertone kind of eyeshadow. The concealer is more cool tone and the eyeshadow is more warm tone, so this is also gonna change the color of the concealer a little bit. So I'm just pressing it over the concealer. Then now for the next color, I'm gonna take the shade named Glam King, which is more of a warm brownish kind of color. And I felt like my crease area was looking really cool tone, so I just went on top of that with this color just to warm it up. So I'm not doing anything special, just applied a tiny layer of that. And then I went in with the color, which is called Look Up, which is a soft yellow color. And I applied a little bit of that at the outer end of where I applied the concealer, just to create a transition from the concealer on the eyelid towards the matte eyeshadow in the outer V. I don't really know how to explain this in English, but you can see me doing it, so hopefully it kind of makes sense of what I'm doing right now. And I really like the soft yellow undertone of this eyeshadow. I think it's really pretty. So now next I'm going back in with the concealer which I used earlier for the eyelids, which is the Benefit Cosmetics Buoyant Cakeless Concealer. I took a Sigma Beauty E25 brush. I applied a tiny bit of the concealer on the brush, and now I'm kind of blending this underneath the outer end of the eyelid. This is gonna make the outer end look more blended out, more clean. I didn't want it to look like really sharp. The effect you will get when you use like some sticky tape or eyeshadow guard. I wanted it to be more soft, and when I want it to be more soft, this is the trick that I do. I just use some concealer with a blending brush. So now next I'm gonna take this eyeliner, which is from Maybelline. It's their Studio Gel Eyeliner. This is actually my favorite drugstore gel eyeliner. I really like it. It's really creamy and it's super black. So I'm gonna create a simple line above the lash line, and then at the outer end I'm gonna kind of apply it more upwards. This is gonna create the effect of wearing sort of a winged liner, but at the same time it's not a winged liner, but I'm not going like further than the eyelids, if that makes sense. Just a little bit, like I'm smudging it out right now, which is kind of gonna create that smudged wink liner without really doing a wink liner. It's kind of hard to explain, but hopefully by seeing me doing it, it kind of makes sense. This is also a nice trick for if you have hooded eyes, because I know a lot of people don't like to wear a wink liner, but try this trick. It will give you the appearance of wearing a wink liner, but you actually aren't. So I really like that. Then now I went back in with the color Glam King, and I took a really tiny blending brush from Suiva, which is more of a shader brush, but like really tiny, and I applied it right above the gel eyeliner. Then I'm gonna take this Morphe Vibes eye pencil, and I'm gonna use it for in the waterline. This is actually one of my favorite pencils for in the waterline. I've been using it so many times on my channel. If you follow a lot of my videos, I'm sure you have seen me using it already a few times before. And it's also super affordable. I think it's only $4, which is so inexpensive. And the color is just really nice. It's really like a warm tone brown, which is gonna make your eye color stand out. Then I took this color, which is called I'm Inspired, and this actually looks really similar to the pencil in the waterline, so therefore I really like to use it underneath the pencil. This way the pencil in the waterline and the eyeshadow underneath it, which I'm applying right now, kind of melts together. And then now to make it less harsh, I'm gonna take the color Glam King again, using a really tiny Morphe M506 brush. And I'm just gonna blend my brush back and forth to really smudge it out and create more of a smoked out effect underneath the lower lash line. I don't really like harsh application underneath the lower lash line, so I always go back in with a lighter color to kind of make it more softer and more blended out. You can already see it if you look at the left eye and the right eye. You can see that the eye I already did looks so much better. So I just keep blending until I was satisfied with how it was looking. And then I took my favorite mascara, which is the Benefit Cosmetics Roller Lash Mascara. I applied a coat on the upper lashes and of course also on the lower lashes. I am going to wear fake lashes today. In one of my previous videos, I think it's two videos back, I did a video wearing no lashes, and you guys actually really liked it. I was really surprised to hear that. But today I used the Puffy lashes from my own lash brand called Annytude. I will put all the products I'm using today in the description bar. And now I'm gonna start with the face. I took the KKWTHE nude lip pencil in the shade number 02, and I used this to line my lips and slightly overdraw to make my lips appear a little bit bigger. This is a really nice brown nude, really pretty. You can use it with a lot of nude colors. Then now I took the KKW lipstick, which is also from the Makeup by Mario collection. It's a really pretty brownie nude matte lipstick. I think it's one of the most beautiful colors. Like when I think of like the perfect nude, I think this is the color that I have in mind. I think it's really pretty. And then I took a concealer brush and I'm just blending around the edges to make sure that the lipstick blends into the lip liner. Then after finish it off, I took this gloss, which is also from the KKW and Makeup by Mario collection. This one kind of They sell it like in combination with the lipstick, so I wanted to use it for my lips as well, just to see how it will look. I'm not a huge fan of lip gloss lately. I used to have a period when I was like always wearing lip gloss, but lately I'm constantly wearing matte lipstick. But today I really like this combination. I think the gloss and the lipstick looked amazing. And now I also use the blush, which comes in the collection. I'm applying it with a blush brush from Suifa on the apples of my cheeks. It's a really beautiful peachy color, which I absolutely love. It reminds me of MAC peaches. And now I'm taking the Bobbi Brown Afternoon Glow Highlighter, which is one of my favorite highlighters. I've been using it so often. It's kind of like a rose golden color. I think it suits so well with my skin color. It's not too golden, not too cool tone. I absolutely love it, and I use it for the cheekbones, a little bit on the forehead, and also a tiny bit on the chin, just to make my skin look nice and glowy.
And then this is the end of the video. I really hope you all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy. This is really helpful for my YouTube channel. Also, I really enjoy playing with this palette. This is the good side. I really enjoy playing with this palette. I really like the eye look. It's kind of a neutral kind of cut crease. It looks like a cut crease, but it's more like a softer version, which I really like. If I would ever marry, this is kind of the eye look that I probably would wear. I just think it looks really sexy, but sultry. I just really like it. So I really hope you guys like it as well. If you recreate this makeup look, definitely tag me on social media. I would love to see it. So just to give you guys my final thoughts, I really enjoy playing with this collection. I liked everything. I liked the lips, I liked the blush, and I really enjoy playing with the palette. So for me, I would definitely recommend it to any of you if you are into those kind of shades. And that was that. I really hope you all enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you all in my next video. Bye! You and I, we are so random. You bring the darkness to the light, split the atom. I ignore the fact that this will never last. Your words come out so soothing that I forget that this thing is confusing. Having such a blast, but don't ask where my head is at. Cause I'm cruising through the rush of us. I don't care about love, just need your touch. Once you do.